What's up guys, it's Max here. Welcome back to another electronics video. This time we'll be making an anti-burglar laser tripwire alarm. In my left hand, I'm holding the laser circuit. So it simply consists of the battery, switch, and a laser that emits a beam straight to the photoresistor here. And as soon as that beam is cut, this alarm goes off. No matter if the laser is still pointing back into the receiver, the beeping just keeps going. So yes, it's a very effective and loud alarm. No matter where you are in your home, you'll definitely hear this alarm going off if anyone goes through this. This is not sponsored, but I just wanted to mention that the components I used for this project I actually bought off of utsource.net, which offer great quality components, and I recommend you guys to check them out. The first step is to put all of the components into a blank PCB. The next step is to solder all of them in place and then connect them up. So now I'll explain you the connections of the circuit. If you're not interested in making it, you can just skip to minute 512. Pin 8 of the LM358 connects to a 10K resistor, which goes down and connects to one end of the photoresistor, and then to pin 3 of the LM358. The other pin of the photoresistor connects to the ground rail. Pin 1 of the LM358 goes to a 220 ohm resistor, which then connects to the middle pin of the BC547 NPN transistor. Pin 2 of the LM358 connects to the front pin of the 10K potentiometer located right here. Another pin of the potentiometer directly connects to pin 8 of the LM358. The left pin of the 10K potentiometer connects down to the ground rail and then also connects to a 100 NF capacitor and then to pin 5 of the NE555. Right now I just covered this side of the circuit board. From the marked end of the transistor, there's a connection going down to pin 4 of the LM358 and then down to the ground rail. The unmarked side of the NPN transistor goes around and hits the 10K resistor, which connects to another 10K resistor, and then to pin 8 of the NE555. And that same point has an overlapping wire which connects to the end of the potentiometer that also goes to pin 8 of the LM358. This 10K resistor goes from pin 8 to pin 4 of the NE555. Pin 3 of this NE555 goes to pin 8 of this other NE555 over here to the left. Pin 2 of the NE555 goes to the unmarked end of the NPN transistor. An overlapping wire from the marked end of the BC547 transistor goes to pin 1 of the NE555, and then connects to the ground rail through pin 1 of the NE555 over here to the left. Moving on to the second NE555, a connection from pin 1 goes to the ground rail, connecting to the negative terminal of the capacitor. The positive terminal of the capacitor goes to pin 2. Pin 3 of the second NE555 connects to a 100K ohm resistor, which connects to pin 6. And pin 3 also connects to the positive buzzer terminal. The negative buzzer terminal goes to ground. Pin 2 of the NE555 connects to pin 6 directly underneath. That's all the connections of this circuit board. I hope that explanation helped. Solder the negative battery terminal to the ground rail and solder the positive battery terminal to pin 8 of the NE555 located in the middle. Solder one wire of the reset button switch to pin 4 of the NE555 and the other wire of the button to the ground rail. Also, be sure to wire up the laser pointer circuit like so. If needed, sandwich some double-sided sticky tape between the battery and the circuit board. Also, be sure to add some double-sided tape to the battery and the laser module. And now the laser tripwire alarm is ready for mounting. Since I'm using a laser pointer module, I can easily just move the laser diode around so that I can adjust where it points to. Make sure the laser diode is pointing straight into the photoresistor. That's a wrap it up for this video, showing you how to make an anti-burglar laser tripwire alarm using this complex circuit that I showed you guys how to make. The diagram is listed in the description below, as well as a Gerber file if you want to make this onto a PCB. So it's a pretty handy thing to have in your home. It is quite practical. I have learned that this thing can stay on for a really long time. Until you walk through, it'll go off. And especially if you make a casing for it, something tougher than cardboard, of course, like plastic or even the metal casing, it'll be hard for the burglars to figure out how to switch this off. You can even integrate this into the walls of your home. If you're lucky enough to find two sockets on each side of a room that exactly sit in line with each other, you may be lucky enough to find something like that in your home and mount these on the inside, and that could be an option. So if you guys enjoyed this video, I'd much appreciate if you give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our YouTube channel with the notification bell on, not to miss any of my upcoming videos. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram at max.imagination. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll see you next week. Peace!